Y'all, Chachanator here, and welcome back for the next game of Civ Wars. For more description on the game or to see the bracket, look in the description of this game, and there will be spoilers because this is a tournament. So if you don't want any spoilers and you want to watch the videos in order, you can follow that in my playlist on the channel. They are nicely numbered on the thumbnails. And I'm gonna assume you've clicked away now. Anyway, so that first game we saw, Chachanator was playing as Mongols, I was playing as Mongols, and Chobar was playing as Franks. So now we've switched civs, so we're gonna see how this game goes. The lag was significantly better. We did not play this on the same night, so that's one thing to note. Yeah, it's always nice to play when there's not so much lag. And I'm going to go for a pretty standard scout build, as Frank's scouts are pretty common. I think I go scouts. Anyway, Chobarba is playing as Mongols. He could go scouts really early up times. Usually Mongols can click up on... They could even click up on 20 populations, what I usually aim for, so only 19 villagers. That's pretty early. That's because of their 50% faster hunting bonus. So you can only do that if you go for the deer and obviously get your boars. And I'm not gonna say you can only do that if you go for the deer, but it's definitely a lot easier. So I usually like to do that, go up really early, get just a few scouts out and switch to archers and just play really aggressive. And I did that decently last game. Obviously losing that villager on the border really hurt me. And what else? Yeah, I just, Chobarba had such a good map to just wall up on. Speaking of maps, let's go ahead and look at maps and not reminisce on last game, and we'll focus on this one. See here, both of us going for our boilers at about the same time. Chobar was just a little behind. Going for four villagers on wood, so we could see a trush from him. He could wall this up and protect this wood and this back entrance very easily. Could wall right into this TC, and again with a good map from Chobarba, although his gold is on the front, so that's not going to be great for him. Plus it's got this hill right here, so that's not good at all. Here's his secondary gold, and his other secondary gold is here? Nope, that's the extra gold here. Wow, that's really forward. That's like halfway to my base, so not great gold placement for him. There is one restart allowed per series, but none of us used them for this one. Gonna throw farm out like typical scout build fashion, and check in my map here. Really easy to wall this off on the front. Not great placement on this front gold. It's surrounded by trees, and it's also right next to this hill. The secondary gold's in a decent spot, and this other secondary gold, it's not terrible. If I scout this well enough, one wall here and then buildings here could actually protect quite a bit of area. But obviously that's a lot of walking time to get there. And then walling this could be easy to just force everything here on the right side, which is what I think I do. I know I wall this off for sure. Excuse me. Just looking for Chobar's base right now. He's doing the same. The score difference is mostly due to scouting. You can see that +2 line of sight for Chobar. He has quite a significant amount of scouting information, more than what I would have. I think everyone got their sheep in. Chobarba did find these deer, because he didn't go for them. Which is kind of strange. If you're playing as Mongols, I would always mill the deer before berries and use that 50% bonus. And it's usually pretty safe to do that, because by the time they finish getting these deer, the other guy will be in fetal age. But they'll already be done, so they can go back and start getting berries or put them on wood or something. Let's see, going for a lumber camp. Oh, Chobarba clicking up on 22 pop, so no really early aggression for him. In fact, losing his scout That's not good. Losing a scout, did he just... Yeah, I don't get that. If you run here and you see a lumber camp, I would stay away from... You know, you have a... Just be careful, because you have a general idea of where the town center will be, and he definitely saw a lumber camp first. The scout came this way, and then circled around this way. But he just obviously wasn't paying attention. Yep, going ahead and walling this front here. Starting to wall off the side. Chirar going up on 22 pop. Chachanator going up on 22 pop as well. Almost the same, identical times. Chirar is probably a little ahead. 70. Yeah, just by a second or two. These berry villagers to the other side. And it's as fast as this game will go. Sorry, I would speed it up a little more in the Dark Ages, but for some reason, Steam is really... It's really a butt when it comes to changing speeds. And Barba up, and Chachanator actually like 3 seconds behind. Not a significant difference. Gonna get the stable out right away. Chobarba just now building his barracks, or finishing his barracks, so late for him to do that. He should have already had that done. Chobarba, let's see what he's gonna go for. I'm gonna assume scouts with these farms here on the front. And there you go, stable. So I know what he's going for now. Gonna try to be a nuisance. He's gonna try to wall off, but then it's not gonna happen. He's getting some free hits there. Slowing down that stable. And then you see Chihuahua's gonna send his spearmen right over there. And yeah, I see you coming. So here you go. Barracks being built probably more like here would have been better to help protect this gold. You know, keep people off this hill. He's kind of trying to funnel it into the main gold, I think, which I don't know if I'd funnel people into my main gold, but we'll see. We'll see how it works out. He may not even try to wall off at all. I'm just trying to go for pure aggression. You see early spearmen for him. I got a spearman out, sending it forward actually, because I know he's going to be defensive. And I kept one back at base, just in case. Going for some more farms, and playing as Franks, so pretty much just want to stick with scouts and knights. Their archer line is pretty terrible, especially in Imperial Age. In Castle Age, they can get fully upgraded crossbows, but Imperial Age, they are terrible. Chasing a scout, and Chivar only on two. Let's check the numbers. Chachanair, wow, lots of spearmen running into them. Never a good idea. Chachanair on the 4. Looks like Chobarba's now on 3, and just spearmen everywhere. You should space him out a little more. But there's really no way to get back here with these scouts anyway. And gonna catch the scout out. So it's gonna be, I think, 2 scouts to 5 now? Or 1 scout to 5? I think it's 1. But lots of spearmen for Chobarba. My spearman's not doing too much over here, because he doesn't have any scouts out. There's a scout. And he get this other scout in here. And yeah, trying to micro that. Definitely not working out too well. 2 spears against 4 scouts and a spearman. I probably shouldn't have done this, but I thought I could. Thought I could guess this. I got 1. Oh, I guess that worked out pretty well. And I think I tried doing it again. Yeah. So, pretty good engagement so far. Chirar getting these villagers involved and gonna wall that off to stop with that ridiculousness. And now, on another scout, I think I've made 6 scouts or 7 scouts, quite a bit to invest in. Chobarba actually has less food and going for double archer rangers, so he's gonna go for archers here pretty soon. Scouts coming in. Gonna pick a villager? No. Had to get away from the spearmen. And, trying to just dodge this. And gonna run through this TC. Chobarba should garrison, but he doesn't. So they get away just fine. And if he's watching, he could have hit those scouts. Gonna pick off another scout here, run away. So, yeah. As long as you micro the spearmen, you know, obviously you have to use them very defensively. And he's got a lot of them, so these scouts are kind of useless. And you see the score difference now swinging in my favor just because I've had a lot better engagements. And I'm looking to get a bunch of farms up and go up here pretty soon. Throwing some villagers on gold. and too much wood. Really too much wood, that's really not a good thing. We need to throw up more farms. You can see I'm doing that now. But I should throw up even more, put more on gold. See, I'm getting my blacksmith out, which is pretty late, but I'm not too worried because I don't have the coal to go up anyway. It's actually a good time to get it out, I think. And Chobarba is a lot further behind. Still making Fetal Age Aggression here and in-house here just for a little bit. Going for a wall off here for his wood line. Kind of this half wood wall off on a wall off and getting away from that Spearman again. And just trying to keep these scouts useful. Going for another engagement, and yeah, I guess wrong. And running into another spear. Yeah. That was bad. Really bad. Yeah, I've already stopped making military because I'm going up castles soon. Gonna get town watch here first. Yeah, probably should have just clicked up. I think I have low barrels check. Come on. Should click up, like now. There you go. And yeah, I do have wheelbarrow. Let's see if Chobarba has wheelbarrow. I'm on his thing. Should. No, he doesn't. So, yeah, again, late on the wheelbarrow. And, he could almost afford it. Yeah, if he stopped all these villagers, he could afford it. But not coming forward, trying to find a way in. Obviously, he'll be able to hit this gold line really easily. These archers, doesn't have too many of them, which is lucky. There's his archers. So, gonna alert me, let me know they're there, and I'm just gonna have to move them. So I think I just move them to this gold mine. Really, really annoying gold feeling here. And I'm gonna start throwing up some sables here so I can start going knights as soon as I go up. So yeah, I have a decent economy. My economy's decently set up for it. Again, too much wood. I should build more farms, which I had moved a bunch of these villagers over to gold. So, trying to just set it up so I can go knights here pretty early. And these scouts. But one of the things I forgot to mention is that Franks, although they are a cavalry civ, they get some of the worst. They get hussars, but their hussars aren't very good because their plus 20% hit point bonus is only applied to scouts. It's only applied to knights, it's not applied to scouts. So, you can see Chobarba now realizing I'm fully walled. Now he sees I'm in castle age, he's probably like, oh crap. And, too much gold. Again, he just really likes to queue lots of villagers on his gold line. He should be clicking up here now. There you go. And, trying to get in. I'm just waiting. There's no reason to go out too early and take excess damage. Just wait. And I think I even got the armor upgrade already. Yeah, I did. Plus one already. And you see, low on gold. Would have been better if I. Oh, I took. That's kind of dumb on my part. I took a bunch of gold miners and put them on building a new TC. And it's slowing down my knight production doing that. And, actually, by doing this, Chobar was keeping my knights from coming out. I was trying to time this better. But I was trying to do it one knight at a time, so my scouts are cleaned up by the spearmen. But that's alright, they did their job. And let's see, this Fetal Age army from Chobar was cleaned up pretty easily. And then send knights over to his base. Chobarba, what is your answer to this? And see, at this point, I would say setting your eco up, I would start building a bunch of farms, throw up some stables, and go for camels. And I did not do that last game, and I can tell you all right now, Chobarba will not do that this game either. Spoiler alert, I know, I've kind of ruined it. Just a teaching moment there. If someone's going knights and you're playing as a civ that gets camels, I always forget that you can get camels. And obviously camels are terrible at raiding, but they are great at taking out knights. And when you're fighting Franks, they're always going for knights. Always. If they're not, then they're a noob. Or they're on some crazy new meta strategy that I just don't know about. So I'm going to try to do the damage while I can while he's still in early ages. This tower is obviously doing quite a bit of damage. And, Chabar, what's he going for? He's now going for cavalry archers, as you can see. He's got the eco set up for it, so not a bad idea. Plus, they get that plus 20 firing rate for being Mongols. So, obviously, definitely a decent strategy to go for. He's just going to have to wait to mass them up before he can take on knights. But once he masses them up, they'll be really annoying for these knights to take on. Chabar is still only on the 1 TC. He's dropping another one. He can't afford it because he built the tower. So he's going to have to either mine stone or build a market, which he can do both. Chachanator on 2 TCs. I'm building a third one over here. So going to have the eco advantage probably. 64 pop for Chachanator and Chobarbra on 66, so pretty even. Throwing a monastery up, gonna go for these relics. Maybe a little early to do that, but I figured it couldn't hurt. And see, I'm kinda running low on gold. I need to keep these stables churning out. I have the plus 2 defense now. These scouts just trying to raid where they can, kill vultures where they can. And I want to keep aggressive. I want to keep these guys in his base. And I know he's going cavalry archers now. And he, yeah, building these houses here. Just try to see him before he gets here. I'm gonna chop that relic off. And there you go. And trying to get in. Quick wall off from Chobarvik. Good job. I'm gonna keep these knights out. Is that even walled off? I guess it is. But I feel like I could have just walked right through there. Well, I'm assuming you can't, but that would have been really sad if you could have. Chobar had the TC queued out here, so he's just losing villagers for free. And, anyway, over here now, raided this gold line. He's got the hill bonus. I'm gonna send some knights over there to help deal with this, and he's missing one of the armor upgrades. He does have bloodlines. So, but he doesn't have enough masses up really to want to deal with this, but I already had these other knights coming to flank him. I could have patrolled that, and I would have gotten him better. So now I have all my knights masses up, and, going for a handcart, and Chabar, please tell me you have a wheelbarrow. Let's find out. Yeah, he does. Okay, good. And lots of cavalry archers for him. He's got a lot. I'm not gonna count all that, but y'all can see it. And fighting under this TC is probably not a good idea. And pull his knights out. And Chabarber is still only on the one TC, so it's gonna be hurting him. But he's clearly going for heavy, heavy aggression. Although he did stop production, and he's got way too much wood. I think a market would be good. And sell some wood and keep making cavalry archers and buy some stone maybe and get another town center out. That would be a good idea. He's just trying to go for the stone. He can't get it in because these knights keep coming in to raid him. And I don't know why he's going for the front stone. He's got this side stone here. I mean, it feels like I just keep raiding it. I'm going for his gold now. These archers really aren't going to be much of a problem. And even these unupgraded spearmen against knights. Fully upgraded now in the castle age, these knights. And Chabar having to run away. And let's see. He doesn't have ballistics, so you see he's just missing. And but he's got the wood. He's got tons of wood, so ballistics would be great. He should definitely already have that. Especially 32 minutes in. Still only on the 3 TCs. Yeah. And knights just kind of roaming around. Chabar now coming in to do his raiding, getting another relican. Just missing that monk. Not sure what this knight's doing. He probably wanted to die. And got to pull the soldiers back. There you go. And oh, he dies. A little too late. And this wood line. There's actually. I thought there was an opening here. I was wondering why Chabar never went in, but this little guy is actually a tree. I think he told me Pussywood's broken on his computer, so he definitely would have seen that. So that's why, I was wondering why he didn't go in there. I was so worried about that, too. I should have walled it up, but I don't know if I ever did. I'm starting to go skirmishers because I know his game's going these cavalry archers, so I'm just kind of throwing out there whatever. I have way too much gold. Although, too much gold at this point, I usually say it's never a terrible thing, because, you know, as Barky Turkman always says, gold is king. But, yeah, definitely I should be taking some villagers and building farms with these gold miners. Throwing up lots of houses. I don't want to get housed. And Chihuahua on 95 pop, Chachanator on 125, and I think most of that's eco. Probably have similar sized armies. Although I have these skirmishers here with almost no upgrades. Getting Podcanero right now. And yeah, their stable wouldn't hurt either. But Chobarba's keeping me from raiding him right now, so that's good for him. And has more cavalry archers, mass at home. Still missing that plus one. Oh, he did get that university up finally, so... Oh, just now getting ballistics. Still tons and tons of wood. A market would be good to balance that out. Obviously, you know, taking his soldiers and building farms with them would be good. And putting them on gold or stone would be good. He needs to start getting Mangadai out, which is his goal here. Stationing these, I'm gonna station these skirmishers on top of this hill, because that's where he keeps coming to raid this gold. It's really ticking me off. Now these soldiers are all garrisoning inside this town center here. These knights need to get out of there. They're tough, but you know, you don't want to be taking all this unnecessary damage. And taking more damage. Chobarba now has ballistics, so he's gonna be doing a lot more damage while I run away. So, good for him. Still missing that plus one defense, though. Not the biggest deal in the world. A knight, interesting. I'm starting to see, I don't know if he has thumb ring or not. This cross, not crossbows, he has skirmishers coming for it. I'm pretty sure I had ballistics. I built a university, I have to have gotten it. And, gonna try to throw that castle up. But having to cancel it right away, because, well, it's just, you know, those knights, too many knights are there. You're gonna have to pull these guys back, and getting pinched with these skirmishers, doesn't really want to fight skirmishers. And these guys, I was trying to get a castle up, but they're gonna just get killed. Town center on the side would be good. Still too many. Still too much gold. I wonder if I knew that relic was there. I did. I should pick that up. How many relics do I have? Two? Oh, I'm missing this. These knights getting mowed down by this town center. Just had a big fight with these cavalry archers. And now just kind of trying to run in the eco to do some damage. And got some more knights coming here. Skirmishers chasing down his cavalry archers, which he does not want to fight. That's why he got a knight. Skirmishers. I think I was trying to find a way out, or try to do some eco damage at least, and not doing, yeah, kind of really big waste of these knights. Don't really want to try to run your entire army somewhere. I killed two villagers, and now my knights are completely stuck, can't get them out, just gonna have to try to fight and do what they can. Worst part about that was I was clicked up imp, so I was already going imp, so I could have upgraded these guys to cavalier and made them a lot hardier, but instead I just lost like, I don't know, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 knights maybe. Now I got knights fighting castles, not a good idea. Skirmishers though, in a pretty good spot, and just trying to keep massing up my military and throwing up more stables now. Cavalier on the way, pretty early obviously, and plate boarding armor, and gonna keep making villagers. I can afford a castle now because I am playing as the Franks. I think their castles are like 450 stone or 465, I think. I'm really not for sure. It's 420. I could do the math, but these guys really can't do much to these skirmishers, which are as upgraded as they're going to get as Franks. They don't get Bracer or Cavalier coming in right when I need it, but they don't get Bracer or they don't get ring armor, I think. Archer ring armor. They do get chemistry though, so chemistry would be good to get. Blast furnace right away. Keep punching out these cavalier. Really could use some more stables, but out of wood. Castle going up. And gonna start massing these cavalier, which are gonna do great against these cavalry archers. Citro Barber now on, just finished his fourth TC, so he's on four TCs. Population 165 for Chachanator, Chobarba 136, pretty big difference, almost 30, over 30. And you can see the score difference is almost 1,000, that's pretty significant at this point. And so I know these guys are coming in now. I think I start trying to spam some skirmishers out. And he's just gonna run in here and try to do as much eco damage as he can. This is actually not walled off anymore because I deleted that little palisade. And skirmishers just try to do as much damage as they can. Cavalier coming in, pushing here, and I'm not too concerned about this. I'm just gonna make skirmishers to handle this and throw in some more stables up on the front just so I can reinforce a little faster. And I don't want to get too comfy here. He does have Mingadai out. Chachanator with plenty of gold, plenty of food, just need to be spending it. And Chobarba with no food. He has wood and gold, but he's just not being able to spend it fast enough. At this point, his cavalry archers aren't going to be doing too great against these cavalier. The obvious answer would be camels, but he obviously can't afford it. And let's see, I'm pretty sure I had paladin. There it is. That upgrade takes forever, but at 58%, 60%, these guys are still doing their job. And it's starting to get cleared out though, but really caused quite a disruption in the eco back here. Really annoying. But this is not looking good for Chobarba. He's running into these skirmishers, which are doing great at just taking these guys down and tanking damage, as well as his cavalier. Complement each other pretty well. If you start making pikemen, these skirmishers would be great at killing those pikemen. Treb's now out, taking down his castle. And really just trying to mass more knights and just sending them into his base now. There's a paladin upgrade, fully upgraded knights, 192 hit points, and there's the GG from Chobarba. And there you have it. He did play pretty decent game, I think. He just got rid early on and was late getting his other town centers up. So he's trying to go, he's trying to go really aggressive with the four rangers, which I really like. But if he can't do the damage, then obviously your eco is going to be a lot less, and so by his eco being a lot weaker, he wasn't able to stop. Since he wasn't able to do the damage, he wasn't able to stop just the mass flow of units I had coming out. Only on 88 pop, on 167 here. So there you'll have it. Frank's gonna go ahead and take this series pretty handedly. First game I played Mongols and lost, and the second game, Chobarba played Mongols and lost, so it's going to be 2-0 to Franks. And let's go ahead and check out achievements. And I actually completely called that wrong. I thought Mongols were going to win this easily, so that's two in a row I called wrong, just guessing beforehand. Let's see. Units killed, 170 to 122. And largest army for Chachanator. Resources gathered. Gold. Not having enough gold here. And the population and villagers was pretty big, actually. And you see those relics actually did nice in generating gold. And anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys next time. I believe the next matchup is going to be Mayans Goth. So those games have not been played yet, but as soon as they are, I'll try casting them and get them out to you. I've actually predicted, my guess is that Mayans will win that one just because they're such a great civ. But we'll see what happens. So look forward to that. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys next time.